One last thing about password hashing. You know, all of this is good to understand. And most modern computers hash passwords in just the same way I showed you. Generally, you can use SHA-256. That works okay. The problem with most hashing functions is that they're designed to be fast. So generally, this is a good thing. You know, if you're going to use this hashing function, you know, to be verifying your cookies and whatnot, yeah, you want it to be fast. You want to slow down your web server verifying, you know, cookie data all the time. But for cases like passwords, when it's much more likely that somebody's going to be trying to brute force you, it'd be really cool if we had a hashing function that was both really good, like SHA-256, but also kind of slow, so that as computers get faster and faster, the hash function stays the same speed. And I'm about to tell you about such a function. It's called Bcrypt. The reason I didn't use it in my last example is because it's not built into Python, so it's not super convenient for me to demonstrate, and I don't want to have, you know, expect you to install it. But you know, in the future, outside this course, instead of SHA-256, use Bcrypt instead, and your life will be better. And what Bcrypt is cool, it basically takes an extra parameter, which is how long do you want this to take? And it's neat. So now you have this function that will stay slow forever because you can make it slow.